Alexander Romanov at 21 years of age. He became the youngest defenseman in Canadiens history to score a goal in the Stanley Cup Final. He and Maroon, the reason why we've got overtime now in Game 4. Chris.
Thank you, Kyle. This has been the best game of the Stanley Cup Final. The question now, will it be the last game? With the captain in the box and still 2:59 remaining, a penalty time to kill.
You know what, on both sides of the ice, it's really one of the reasons why both these clubs are here. Tampa with their power play and Montreal with their penalty kill. Which one will bend?
Overtime series winners by Martinez Kane in 2010, Martinez 2014, Jason Harnett in 2000, Brett Hull with his goal in 1999. Since that Juve group goal, and here we go with overtime game 4, and the Lightning a goal away from a Stanley Cup championship. Cirelli with point, getting it organized. Again, lots of time with the man advantage on the double minor as Cirelli brings it in. Edmund in support, and Cirelli spins it behind the net. Edmund's in time to fire that one high and down the ice.
What a start to kill off 40 seconds with all neutral zone play. And again, very aggressive in the forecheck for the penalty killers like they have been successfully all year long.
Cirelli turns it back and Sergachev back in his own zone. Looking up ice, Byron and Evans on the kill, and they're turning back again as the first 2 minutes of the double minor has gone away. Two shots in the first half. They came in the third period. Boards in, feeds back for Sergachev. And now they get it set up. Tyler Johnson, Sergachev, and Andre Palat. Sergachev, the former Montreal Canadian. Palat. Sergachev trying to get it through that maze of players. Hit traffic en route. Gerard Asford along the boards. And a battle for it. It comes back to Sergachev. Palat's got it. He'll fire it, and Gary Price able to fight that one off. Tough stop.
We've seen so often Tampa look so confident on the power play. And Chris, you know, you draw up plays, you practice your power play, but you never practice your power play with the Stanley Cup as the end result when you score. Right? I mean, you could just tell it's a little bit different. They're a little bit hesitant, and I think the penalty kill is taking advantage of that, trying to be aggressive.
Cirelli wins the draw and Stamkos gets it back. Victor Hedman right on. Cirelli trying to pry loose the puck, but Price able to freeze it.
What a great battle there for Carey Price. It's the stick of Cirelli. Can he get to the puck first? The one draw back to the point. A little bit of traffic in front, and Price didn't quite get it clean right off the bat, but able to find the rebound.
On the draw, it's pulled back again to Hedman. Band on that, and it's worked out. And Deneau now charging down the ice. He's got Suzuki to the net, and a big stop by Vasilevsky. What a chance, shorthanded. Back the other way, a lead feed too far for Stamkos. Well, the Canadians, as you suggested, with a penchant for shorthanded goals, had their chance. Victor Hedman down low in front, and Cirelli steers that into the corner. Hedman again, one-timer, Stamkos missed stick side. 40 seconds left in the double minor. Hedman to reload, down low, in front, loose puck in. Point is stopped on the backhand by Price.
What a start to this first overtime as end-to-end action. Not often you see Hedman fumble the puck, then fumble his footing. Now Deneau gets pressure to the outside. This is a long way away. Look at the reach by Suzuki. Couldn't quite get it up over the pad of Vasilevsky. And then Carey Price on the doorstep. Traffic in front. Once again holding on. And a timeout called. I would imagine it would be John Cooper. I just have a quick look here.
Four shots in the second half of this 4 minute power play for John Cooper's crew.
What a start though, penalty killing wise, as the frustration was the fact that they couldn't get the setup. Suzuki trying to look at that. This is a hard play for Suzuki. Got to keep your legs moving. Now look at the aggressiveness of Vasilevskiy sliding across, taking the bottom of the net away. He knew that it was a reach for Suzuki. There wasn't much he could do with that. And Vasilevskiy shut the door.
Sharon sends out a couple of centers, Evans, and of course Deneau, 11-8 for the faceoff circle. Cirelli to do the honors for the Lightning, and from the draw, control by Deneau, and around it goes. Kucherov there for Tampa Bay, watched by Evans in it. Haskins all the way by Hedman and down the ice.
And hit the foot of Kelly Sutherland, and that's why Kucherov was so upset. He was trying to throw that one back. It ended up hitting the skate and going all the way out.
Kucherov back in, checked on the play and lofted it out. It's almost going to do it as Weber gets set to return. Lead feed for Stamkos. Weber's back, point, looking for Kucherov. So as Cassie mentioned, they got the kill for their captain. But pressure continues here. Kucherov's out along with Stamkos. Played along the boards off the skate, and up comes Suzuki. Nick Suzuki inside the line, waiting for some fresh troops to arrive. Caulfield's come over the boards, but it's played ahead for Barclay Goodrow, and now Point staying out there for the Lightning. Braden Point with a move to the outside against Petrie. Swoops it around behind the net, back to Chernak. His shot knocked down in the slot. Barclay Goodrow trying to come out of the corner. Romanoff lost it. Coleman. Anderson takes it away from him. Chips it past Ruda. He's got Caulfield in front. And a center play. Caulfield. Anderson scores! Josh Anderson extends the series. Canadians stay alive. And there it will be Game 5. And the series goes back to Tampa Bay.
You know, the penalty kill did their job, and now Anderson, who hasn't been playing for a while because of it, watch the play he makes in the defensive zone. Lifts the stick of Gord, uses his best skill, which is his speed, but the key, he doesn't go by the net, stops on the net, gets to it before Ruda can. Caulfield keeps it alive in front. The speed of Anderson made this possible, but him stopping and getting back to the front of the net makes that goal happen. Kept the play alive right here with a little tip back off of the stick of Yanni Gord, and then diving back, Josh Anderson sends this back to Tampa for game number 5.
3:57 of overtime, about a minute after the double minor had been killed. Scored an overtime winner against Vegas in game 3 and a game 4 winner here tonight.
You know, you're thinking defense first. That's his all notice there, but then just an excellent read. Then a little chip. Now it's a foot race, and this last effort to throw that puck out in front creates the second chance as Caulfield gets a piece of it. This crowd had anxious moments with a 4-minute penalty kill. Carey Price, think of those saves. We've talked about his calm all throughout the playoffs. Games 1 through 3 didn't go his way. Game 4 sends it back to Tampa Bay.
32 stops for Carey Price tonight. And now 4-0 when facing elimination in these playoffs. What a night here in Montreal. My legendary colleague Dick Irvin used to say, well, his dad had the quote, never lose your last game at home, and the Canadians have at least kept their season alive here tonight to take it back on the road. So a spectacular night, the 3-2 win for the Canadians. Let's join Rob McLean.